2011, the GLBT community came together to remember those we have lost, to hate, and to dedicate a small garden as a lasting place of reflection. This effort was sparked to life as a reaction to a recent murder that took place in Houston. A young gay man named Aaron Scheerhoorn had been stabbed and was running from his attacker. Upon seeing a nightclub, he ran to the club's entrance seeking help. The doorman turned him away, whereupon Aaron's attacker pushed him down and in front of dozens of onlookers commenced to stabbing Aaron over and over again. The onlookers did absolutely nothing to stop the attack and allowed the murderer to escape without hindrance.
The suspect actually pursued him all the way to the front steps of the club here and in front of numerous patrons here. Just commenced to stabbing them numerous times.
This place of remembrance is significant to me because a third of those remembered that night were transgender. As a case manager in social services, I had worked with more than one of these women. I want to thank you for watching this video. It helps me to know that the tragedy, the brutality, and injustice they suffered isn't whitewashed or forgotten. It helps me to know that others will at least remember their names. And I guess, if anything, I hope this place of remembrance might inspire others to consider the price the innocent pays for our culture's need to cling to hate.
And if you will look at the three dozen, a third of them are transgender. A third of them are people of color. The least honored in this group have been the transgender people. And so I want you to take a minute to think of them and think of the pain they have gone through because they have been bullied, they have been taunted in school, they have been murdered.
Hate crimes. Rodney did, and everyone did a great job. I just went into the legislature in 93 when the attempt to pass hate crimes occurred. And just like everywhere in this country, the idea is to have people from the GLBT community protected. But I want to talk to you about the T, because in no bill is there protection for transgendered individuals. And I've been filing a bill to include transgendered people in the hate crimes bill. And it's very clear that because of that, we're not finished with our work until everyone is protected under the hate crimes legislation that we have.
We are lighting candles tonight, and you all know this drill. Candles, the fire on them symbolizes our memory, and it symbolizes our sadness. The fire also is our anger. The fire that we're spreading is our power. The fire that we're lighting is our ability to change the world. Our fire is our power for healing. Our fire is the goodness that's within each one of us. So as I read these names and we begin to light our candles slowly, 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 as the names are read, our power and our love and our strength will be growing as you light your candle and pass it to the next and pass it to the next. And then as our power and our love and our strength grows and reaches a grand potential, we'll move and we'll walk over to the garden and we will surround the memory of those victims with our love. Stanley Sinclair. Fred Hayes. Gail Sweet. Marion Cancer. Charles Hebert. Jose Chima Silva. Thomas Hamilton.
Paul Broussard, Juan Manuela Meyer Laris, Philip Smith, Michael Berzinski, Fred Mangione, Mark Cox, Laren Morris, Kevin Child, Steve Blaine Garcia, Brian Chadwick Good, Julia Carazales, Darren Brandy Honeycutt, Francisco Javier Luna, Nathan Mayoral, Phoebe Varaya, Michael Charles Hurd, Hendrick Cinnamon Perry, Ross Allen, Randy Wilson, Christina Smith, Kenneth Cummings Jr., Noel Daniel Davis, Myra Channel Eichel, Gypsy Rodriguez, Asher Brown, Joshua Wilkerson, Aaron Michael Scheerhoorn, Nene Davis, and all those victims unknown to us.
Referee Rodriguez, Freddie Jensen, who lost her youngest son in 2008. She's here and she's going to share some words with us about hope and healing.
The choice is not gay or straight, but rather love or hate. We all make constant choices because we're human beings, whether to live lives based on fear or love. The problem with our world today is that we have unhealthy fear all around us. Our world is filled with unhealthy fear. All we have to do is turn on the television or the radio or pick up a newspaper or go online. And we have people willing to tell us 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, what we need to be afraid of. And if we forget what to be afraid of, they gleefully remind us what to be afraid of at no additional cost. It's always there for us. We chose to leave fear behind tonight, no matter what label was put on that fear. Each one of us has chosen to live this night based on love. And each one of us has chosen to step forward and celebrate those whose lives were taken.
Spend all your time waiting for that second chance before a break that would make it okay. There's always some reason to feel not good enough. And it's hard at the end of the day. From this dark cold hotel room and the endlessness that you feel, you are pulled from the wreckage of your silent reverie.
But I just had to thank you so much for talking about the transgender folks. It was back in 2000, I came and visited your office. We had had a transgender shelter, and I had talked to you about that. We had to close, and Cinnamon had come to us looking for shelter as we were closing, and we had to turn her away. And it was 2 weeks later that she was murdered. So I just thank you so much from the bottom of my heart.
You can rest assured that my commitment is real, and we shouldn't rest until we have finished with the inclusion of everybody in protection and in our hearts and minds. And we have not done that yet.
Thank you.
So So.
We got HISD too.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Well, I understand, but we just have, you know, we can't have a hate crimes bill without transgender people in it.
I really appreciated you saying that. Thank you. And also saying it's not just when someone in the suburbs gets killed. Every victim is a victim.
It's just like, you know, when the police beat the kid, not this kid, but I said, well, who's the victim's rights person for the when the police are the ones that are beating the victim? I mean, so, you know, I mean, I just say all that to say that, you know, we have to, it has to be everybody.
Thank you.
But you know what? When we have elected officials standing up there saying it, that's progress.
Well, thank you. That's very nice.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Roster of bills that you have gotten through has been the most courageous legislation.
We did pretty good.